As Minnesotans, we have an incredible and diverse history. Our ancestry is Native American and French, Scandinavian and German, and more recently, Somali and Hmong. Do you know your family's history and why they came here? Well, tonight, with the help of Ancestry.com, I track down the Minnesota secrets in my family that have been hidden for four generations. The sign in tiny Bergen in southwestern Minnesota says, Velkommen. I've come here with many questions, knowing my Swedish ancestors were at some point, somewhere nearby.
Where in this giant state was my family more than 100 years ago? And I've never been able to answer that question.
Michelle Erkenbrack from Ancestry.com has answers in the form of the 1895 Minnesota State Census.
And this shows Nicholas.
Right. That's my great-great-grandfather.
Correct, yeah. So this is Nicholas. He's 58 years old. Him and his wife, Joanna, are from Sweden.
Right.
He's a farmer.
Nicholas, who also went by Nils, was a farmer here in Christiana Township in Jackson County. We head a mile north of Bergen and onto a dirt road that says dead end. But at the end of this dead end are answers I've been searching for decades. Joining us is Mike Kirchmeyer with the Jackson County Historical Society.
They would have owned 80 acres.
Incredible.
Off in that direction.
So right here is literally the corner of their property.
Right.
Mike discovered a property map from the 1890s showing exactly where the Lunns lived and farmed.
For the first time in three generations of my family, it's like a mystery is solved, you know. My grandpa, Bill Lunn, used to tell me we were farmers in Minnesota, and for decades I've wondered about that, I've thought about that, I've reflected on that.
Turns out the Lunns were on this property for at least 10 years. Nils and wife Joanna owned and farmed this 80 acres from 1887 until at least 1897. By 1900, they moved to Chicago. But this discovery leaves me with more questions. How did my great-great-grandfather get from Sweden to this Minnesota farm field? And why did he leave his homeland? For that, we head to Minneapolis to the Turnblad Mansion and the American-Swedish Institute. Inside, more Lunn family secrets, including one bombshell.
I want you to kind of think for a minute what it would be like to learn that your last name could have been something else.
That would be, I mean, I'm getting goosebumps. I mean, I'm glad I'm sitting down, you know. So it would be shocking. That would really be stunning.
Okay, yeah. We actually, this is an instance where we've proved the family rumor to be true.
Oh my gosh.
Yes.
I am really stunned here.
So what this is an immigration record out of Sweden. Uh-huh.
I look down at the record and realize my last name shouldn't be Lunn at all.
It's Nils Johnson.
Oh my gosh. I have heard some people have said Johnson.
Really?
Yes. And I don't know where that comes from, but one of my relatives even speculated maybe the name's Johnson or they thought the name was Johnson. That is unbelievable. So my name is not even Lunn at all. I mean,
it is.
But not on that line.
And the story revealed by Ancestry.com is that Nils Johnson was born in Oxie, Sweden, near the city of Lund in 1836. His father, Johns Johnson, the victim of a horrible tragedy.
Oh, my gosh.
He drowned.
He drowned. How terrible.
It's awful.
So he died a tragic death. That would be my great-great-great-grandfather.
Right.
That left Nils fatherless at the age of four. And with two older brothers in Sweden at the time, that meant third in line to any family, property, or farm.
And what we have right down here at the bottom mm-hmm. is Nils Johnson, and it says Fiske, which is fisher. So he's a fisherman.
Oh, well, that explains a lot.
Nils was a fisherman in nearby Helsingborg, and in the late 1860s, he left for America.
So at immigration, likely, mm-hmm. my family's name changed from Johnson mm-hmm. to Lunn. Mm-hmm. I am absolutely floored. I mean, I am just shocked.
Well,
now I'm the most common name in the phone book.
Bill Johnson? I know, right?
The name Lund likely came from the city in the Swedish region from which he came. And despite 10 years of farming in Minnesota, decades more as a laborer in Chicago, Nils Lund may have felt his American dream fell short.
But he's someone that maybe if he wasn't able to live that dream for himself, he gave everything he had so that his children would be able to live that dream.
Yep.
his son, a firefighter, his grandson, my grandfather, a lawyer, his great-grandson, my father, a Navy vet and ad exec, and myself all realized the American dream because of the path that Nils Lunn blazed.
Had to save a little dirt. Ancestry also tested my ethnicity based on my DNA. There were a few surprises there as well. So if you're feeling inspired to track your family's history, we can help. We've set up a number of resources to get your search started. You'll find them in our interactive web center at KSTP.com. I'd also like to hear from you about your family history. Email me or find me on Facebook and Twitter.
That's
and I want to
so
introduce
cool.
myself. I'm Bill Johnson. It's nice,
nice
to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Bill. Gosh, that just must have sent chills up your spine.
It did. It was really a surprise to learn that because, you know, I've never heard that before.
I'm sure it changes the way you view everything that you have today, huh?
Yeah, it's fascinating to connect with the past.
Yeah, that is so cool. Thanks a lot.